his objectives, select a speech topic and determine its general and specific purposes. Organize the speech in a manner that best achieves those purposes. Ensure the beginning, body and conclusion reinforce the purposes. Project sincerity and conviction and control any nervousness you may feel. Strive not to use notes. Time, 5 to 7 minutes.
Yeah, let me introduce Sambit. Sambit is working as a general manager.
His title is Pursue or Passion. It's a very interesting title. So, Mr. Sambit, please.
Yeah, so let me introduce. He is working as a general manager, Idea Cellular. And he is a workaholic person who loves to work a lot in day and night. And he is very passionate, passionate for perfection. He wants to perfect whatever he is doing. That is his temperament. Last week, Sambit delivered a speech, you know, and very quickly he has come up with the next one. I invite Sambit.
Yeah, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
The topic, the title itself doesn't go with real honesty in my personal life. So I think I'll be the better speaker to talk about it because I'm not going to deliver that.
Pursue your passion. It's a very simple thing, but it's a very difficult thing, which has taken almost, now I'm 39. If I live about 5 years of my childhood, so 35 years, 34 years. 34 years in life, the first 15 years, maybe because of resource constraints, I could not pursue some of the passions that I had. Last 20 years, I've been working. I've been able to take care of myself. I could have done anything that I wanted. But at the end of 39th year also, I've not been able to do it. I had a very small passion. I played a lot. I'm a good sportsman. But somewhere I had within myself, I need to play instrument. I wanted to play guitar. I wanted to play something. I started off, gave up in 5 days' time. I bought a guitar, gave it up. But somehow I could not play that no instrument. Last 6-7 months I have been into walking because I have not put a lot of weight. So while walking also I put on my Walkman. Nowadays we are using our handset. And I play one song repeatedly just to remind me that I need to play the guitar one day. And I hear that song from Kurt, we just got a spring. And I want to play someday, but still I'm not going to do it. Fortunately, my CC3 came in. I thought, let me do some research on this. Why is that I'm not going to play? What is the real constraint that I got as a professional? I was going through some of the articles. Not very good at reading, but for the example of the Google. Tim Ferriss has written a beautiful book. I've just clicked through few pages. Don't have so much patience to go through the entire book. But few pages and some rules are really touched me. And honestly, like my last piece that I delivered, the few basics that possibly we don't do. If I talk more about me, I'm pretty sure most of you sitting here also will have some pattern which we might not have been able to accomplish. Now, all of us who are staying in urban area, it's but natural that all of us
maybe somebody is a student, maybe somebody like me is a professional, maybe somebody like my wife might be a homemaker, or maybe somebody like you might be an entrepreneur. One thing is common. What is that? All of us play full-time role. All of us play full-time role. In fact, if you really flashback, entire day of the 24 hours, we spend time playing our role. And then whatever little time is left over, we try to run and live our lives. See, we are living our lives, but we have hardly got much time if you reflect back. Because the entire day we spend through our full-time role. So from here, what I want to start. There are three simple rules which I picked up, which I think I can at least try and use in my personal life. Maybe after 6 months I might play a guitar for you guys. You never know. But anyway, these are three simple rules and by end of my speech, I'll possibly be able to get through the subcritical knowledge. The first rule, don't do anything that you don't have to do. When I go back to office, like yesterday was Saturday, we moved to office. We end up doing a lot of things, maybe which if I don't do, nothing is going to happen. But invariably, each of us try to do something which we don't have to do. So now, if I give some examples on that. If you can talk to somebody, if you can respond to some issue over a mail, I don't think anybody need to talk to that mail. You just try it out. There is an issue from somebody and you just need to reply him back. Maybe the reply might take 2 minutes, but once you call him up, it takes 10 minutes. If you can talk to somebody over phone and you don't have to meet him, I think it'll save half an hour. If you can speak to the guy over phone and try to sort out his issue, there's an issue which you have to address. Maybe pick up the phone, talk to him. But once you are meeting the gentleman, maybe you are taking 20 more minutes because there is something that you have to start off with. So 30 minutes we can save if the problem can be solved just by sending a mail. We all access our mails. We are all on the touch phones, on the smartphones. So maybe we need to get into the habit of trying to do our things at the easiest possible way, saving time for us. We can really save 30 minutes for one problem to be solved. Now, if you can shop for the month for your grocery, or if you shop for the week for your vegetables, possibly don't get into the habit of going to the shop every day to buy something. 10 minutes you take to go to the shop, 10 minutes you buy and make the payment, 10 minutes you go, come back, 30 minutes. 30 minutes in 6 days is quite a good time that we lose. So maybe we can save some time on this. Most of the people love to go to the shop and while walking go and buy something, come back in terms of the vegetables. So maybe we can look into this. We always should try to take the assistance of people, the second rule. There are a lot of things that can be outsourced. There are a lot of things that you can actually do, make others do for you. But invariably we feel that no, we should do it. Because if I don't do it, the thing is not going to get completed. Maybe I am trying to be too perfectionist. Not required. If I have got a guy who is taking care of my MIS, he can take a lot of things that I don't have to do. But sometime or most of the time you will see that you get into those activities which possibly the time spent is too expensive for you. Your time is too valuable. A guy who is there to assist you, his time is not as expensive as yours. So you don't have to spend that time. Please outsource it. Third is, there are a lot of repetitive things that we do, like making your credit card payments, making electricity bills. If today in the environment where you've got everything automated, when you've got everything that can be paid online, every time an electricity bill comes, either I pay the dues as a late file, or I really struggle to keep my checks ready. Not required. One instruct to the bank, the payment is done. When you have got the intention to make payment on time. So most of the time we waste our time trying to do all these things. Your credit card bills. A lot of time we waste our time, and in fact we build a lot of stress on ourselves, because most of people who use a credit card doesn't know to use the credit card in a very smart way. So this is a third, this is a repetitive thing that possibly when you take use of the system, you take use of the technology, you possibly can save a lot of time. So maybe these are three basic rules that I personally feel, as an individual I waste a lot of time. I really waste a lot of time, and every time morning I walk in the road here, hear the string, and then I think I'll play one day for my son, but that never happens. Last 6 months has never happened. I hopefully, maybe another 6 months, one evening I might call off you for evening Toastmaster on a Sunday and might play for you. Thank you very much, and I think this you people should also try it out in case you have got something to pursue in your life. Thank you very much.